Any health-related information on the following show provides general information only. Content presented on any show by any host or guest should not be substituted for a doctor's advice. Always consult your physician before beginning any new diet, exercise, or treatment program.
Welcome to Accelerated Health Radio on W4HC Radio, where you can learn to accelerate your body, mind, and spirit to reclaim the true potential that exists within you through cutting-edge wellness tools and modalities. Here's your host, Sara Banta.
Welcome to Accelerated Health Radio today on W4HC and W4CS. I'm your host, Sara Banta. I'm a health coach, natural supplement expert, and a busy mom of three teenagers. And for you that have been joining us for the first time today, I graduated from Stanford University as well as the Institute for Integrative Nutrition and the Invincible Wellness System, where you essentially become your own doctor with the natural supplements at hand. As I was on my own journey for my own health after hitting rock bottom probably about 10 to 12 years ago with hormonal issues, thyroid issues, literally no digestion, and having Crohn's disease, I was introduced to holistic modalities, supplements, nutrition, and cutting-edge technologies that heal the body. And partially through my journey, my 9-year-old son at the time, Jackson, was diagnosed with leukemia. It was just heartbreaking. And I had been introduced to a supplement now known as accelerated silver, which is a scalar silver, not a colloidal silver. And you can find that on my website, acceleratedhealthproducts.com. That's what I started giving to him. And in addition to cleaning up his diet, and within a year, not only were the cancer cells gone, but the anemia and the other nutritional deficiencies he had had and his acidity in his blood were all gone. He's now 17 years old. He's never missed a day of school from the cold or flu in the last 8 years. He's a national record holder for crew. And he truly has been my inspiration to stay on top of the cutting edge modalities and supplements that go after curing the incurable and helping my clients live their most optimal lives in body, mind, and spirit. And I truly believe that the body does want to and is capable of rebuilding and healing itself, regardless of what incurable or chronic disease you may have. I'm here to answer your questions and bring you innovative and cutting-edge technologies and health solutions to empower you and your ability to reach your optimal state of health. So now to introduce my guest to help you along that way is Michael McEvoy, CEO of Wellana and founder of the Aqua Chi foot bath. Michael is a passionate health advocate and consultant working in the health and wellness arena for almost 20 years. He operates several businesses, including the AquaChiFootBath.com, which we'll talk more about today, and we'll discuss what it is, how it works, and a whole lot more. Michael, welcome.
Well, it's nice to be with you.
Why don't we start with how you got yourself to where you are today, and how did you get yourself on the alternative path and then the world of health and eventually Ionic foot baths?
Well, Sara, I'm going to say that in your introduction, I share your philosophy about life, about that there's no limitation on what the body can do to heal itself. And so that exploration for me began in my 20s when I had some serious back issues. And, at that age, I thought it was all mechanical, you know, that it's just muscles and, you know, getting your joints in place. But I learned, you know, in my 20s that it's a process of understanding your body and then following some guidance inwardly about the things that are going to help. So that journey helped me to get into the area of alternative wellness and the questioning of what was available to me or what the doctors and chiropractors, et cetera, might have prescribed didn't always do the trick. So I had to learn a lot about nutrition and taking care of the body in various other ways. So
very similar to me. And so what did you start out with, and then how did that end up? How did you find the foot bath?
Well, actually, the foot bath, it was probably in my later 30s that me and my wife at the time had attended a health conference, and there were these gentlemen from Australia who were demonstrating this. At the time, it wasn't called the Aqua Chi foot bath, but it was a bioelectric treatment for the body in the form of a bath that you put your feet into. I was interested. I have to say, my wife at the time was more kind of like, yeah, this is cool. You know, we have to look into this. A long story short, we did begin on a path of using that, and then beginning to learn exactly what the bath has done for people. Some of the things that the Aqua Chi early on, this is back in 96 or so, there was just a slew of testing that was being done even then. And in the more recent past, we have now doctoral dissertations on how effective it is and where it's headed. So we're getting more and more answers as time goes on as to how it works, what the mechanism is.
So for the listeners, I just want you to know that my feet currently, as I'm talking, are in a foot bath. And I've been using this for about 3 to 4 years and have seen amazing results from it for me and my kids and my husband. He's not as determined to, I throw a lot of supplements and diet stuff at him, so he can only take so much. But I find the foot bath extremely relaxing. And it's helped with water retention for me, and the color of it when I'm done, I feel like I've done something very productive, because I see all the toxins that are sitting in that water, and it becomes very dirty. If anyone's not familiar with what a foot bath does. And so maybe what you can walk us through right now, and then I can share a little bit more about my experience, but how does it actually work?
Okay, so it falls in the area of what's called bioelectric dynamics, and what basically, to try to give it a very simple explanation, if you consider your body, you've got billions of little batteries in your bodies called cells, and the cells require some bioelectric charge, electrical charge around the cell in order to function. And so, in short, what happens over time when the body becomes diseased or is challenged in health, the action of the cells is depleted. The electrical activity that helps the cell to assimilate and eliminate begins to get sluggish, for lack of a better word. And that's the precursor to disease. You feel it, viscerally within your body by the symptoms of, when you're run down, energy levels are low, you probably have a sense that something's not right in your body. So what the Aqua Chi does is it imparts a bioelectric charge into the water, which is then transferred to the body. So you're sitting right now with your feet in a bath. Imagine the blood circulating through your body, and it's going at a speed of upwards of 200 miles an hour. This is how fast your blood is actually circulating through your body. So when it passes through your feet, this is where it has the ability to impart that charge. The bath imparts the charge to your body, and then these cells are carried throughout the body, and that begins this process. You mentioned that there is a effect on the water, and that is, it's a byproduct of the bath. What we've seen is that, dependent on the ability of your body to take on this bioelectric charge, if it's inefficient, the water will tend to be darker. And just like a battery, when you're charging a battery, some old batteries don't charge as well as fresh batteries. And so in the case of the Aqua Chi, if you're very healthy and your body is working optimally, you'll tend to see a lighter outcome in the bath. And this, it can change from week to week, from day to day as well. So that gives an idea that, you know, basically the darker the water, the more reflective that is of the need for the charge being given. Does that make sense?
It does. Does it have anything to do with the water that I'm using in the bath from the city? You know, for if it's coming out of my sink, and I've heard that maybe the resource of where the city's getting the water this week versus a month ago has changed. So maybe the water is going to be worse or better.
Yes.
And react different. So
right.
Can you
yeah.
explain that?
Yeah, there's definitely a component with the water being used. So from in different regions of the country, there'll be a different hue to the water. For instance, some areas, there might be an iron-rich water, which would lead to a more brownish color. Other areas, it might be a slightly green color. So the local water supply definitely has an impact. And for the people who are using RO water or distilled water, using a little bit of a sodium for conductivity in the water will also have its own characteristic that way.
Right. I do find that I need to add a little sodium to my water to get it to the proper voltage. Is that the right? Okay.
Yeah. It's got to have the right conductivity. That's right.
Yes. Aaron is asking, is there a proper way to discard the water after use? Now, I personally just throw it in the toilet. Is that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's easy to do. Yes, it is toxic water. I mean, it's not dangerous because would that be correct?
It's not even terribly toxic. It's really just byproducts, which are naturally occurring minerals. And in the body, you know, some people have said, well, you know, it's removing all the toxins out of my pores. You know, there is some truth to that on right below the surface of the skin. But by and large, what's happening is that you're naturally secreting, in waste, what the result of the bath is. So it increases the cell's ability to eliminate, and then through natural elimination, that's where the bulk of what your body discharges comes from. In answer to Aaron's question, though, it's perfectly okay to discard of it the water in the toilet. And also, believe it or not, many people will actually use the water in their garden because it's actually very good for plants. That's one of the things that was found early on. It was actually the technology was used in the farming arena, and so. By charging water, as we do in a foot bath, it was found that the yields on growth in crops is significantly improved. You know, so that's just a tip for the people at home. You know that you can use it to help grow things in your garden as well.
Oh wow! And Renee is asking, do you believe that the spring or distilled water is better? Or to make the process better versus the tap water out of my sink?
Actually, tap water is fine. It really comes down more to the conductivity in the water. If you're using what's it called? Where you put sodium into the water. I forget the name of it, but it's a conditioner. If you use a conditioner in your house, which treats hard water.
Oh, softening. Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
A softener.
Yes, exactly. That can kind of, that has more conductivity in it than normal water. So you would have to just judge on the Aqua Chi. There's a meter that tells you the conductivity that's taking place. And so in some areas you have natural conductivity. In others, you need to add a little salt for the conductivity. But what water you're using really doesn't matter so much. So it'll, for most people, tap water is just fine.
Okay. A question, because I'm a biohacker. I love to test things and see if something's going to improve another modality or to make me feel better or worse. And sometimes it's too much to detox too much at a time and that sort of thing. Is there any supplement or a time of day or anything to enhance the results better than something else? Have you found or is it just straight? Doesn't really matter. Do it when you can. Doesn't matter if you're taking extra minerals before or extra detoxifying supplements and that sort of thing.
Right. Yeah. So by and large, you don't have to do anything majorly different. I'll just share, though, for patients, there's a lot of people who are using the Aqua Chi for treating their, you know, their own cancer or other diseases. We do advise people who are taking, say, chemo to take that well before you do an Aqua Chi, and then the Aqua Chi will help to eliminate what comes in the bloodstream after a treatment like that. So we say in that order because it's better to do one after this has been in your system than before. Does that make sense?
Yep. And so is that why it's sometimes called a detox foot bath?
Yeah, it is. It's gotten that name. I think partially it's because, you know, the color of the water is, you know, that's kind of for people doing it for the first time. They're like, wow, you know, that's wild, you know. But in fact, the real detox happens as you do this over time because your cells are getting improved level of performance, and you know, it helps your to renew the cells in your body.
So it, would that be why? And that when we first got the foot bath, the color of the water was much more tame or not as dark as then after a few times. It's almost like the body hadn't started releasing the toxins yet, and then all of a sudden the floodgates were open and it learned how to let go of the toxins. Am I saying that right, or is that just me making that up in my mind?
I think it really goes, it's an up and down process. It's not a, we can't draw a line from one from the beginning to the end and see, you know, that results change in line with an exact, you know, time period or something like that. It tends to be, it go in cycles, you know, just like you do in your life, you know, so you can see that. But actually what we see more is that when people first start doing it, it tends to be darker and then it lightens over time. So it all depends on all these variables we talked about with the water and that kind of thing. But the activity in the water, you can notice the changes that happen from bath to bath. And usually there's something, you know, that's going on at those moments that can be reflective of what's happening in the water.
Do you worry about mineral loss, like potassium and magnesium and the good stuff coming out of your body as well as all the toxins?
Actually, that's one of these myths that have arisen, you know, with foot baths and the Aqua Chi in general, is that there is no, the body knows what to do with minerals that are good for it. So there is no release of anything that is nutritious to the body. Okay. The cellular activity in your body, the wisdom within the body knows what's toxic and knows what to release. So in actuality, taking some minerals like you've described there actually might be a good thing before a bath because it's going to increase the activity of the cells because of those nutrients being brought into the body. That kind of answers a question you asked earlier.
Yes. Okay. Is there any research that's been done on the Aqua Chi?
There's been plenty of research over the years. We've got a voluminous amounts of research. You know, if anyone's interested, you could visit us at aquachifootbath.com and just leave a note to request some of that research. But I'll share with you in the more recent past, there is a woman by the name of Dr. Marcy Purnell, who really did some groundbreaking research with the using the Aqua Chi at the University of Tennessee. She did a doctoral dissertation using this. And I won't go into too much detail with it, but I'll just say this, that she was working with healthy cells and cancerous cells in vitro. What she found is basically that when they're treated, healthy cells, now we're talking about treating them in the charged water from an Aqua Chi, the healthy cells, the activity actually increases in the cell, right? So the activity of the cell is increased or enhanced, and then that includes the growth of the cell. So that's a healthy sign. But the most interesting thing was the cancerous cells that were treated actually didn't reproduce. They reproduced at something like 90% less in terms of the activity of the cell. So it halted the cancerous cell growth. Now, not exactly sure, but the theory is that when the cancerous cells are given this charge, they begin to take on the characteristics of a healthy cell again. And by doing that, they kill themselves off because they're acting normally again. So I hope that was a good explanation. I'm not sure.
No, it is. And it reinforces the idea that the cancer cells are not the strong cells in the body. And the body does want to heal itself. So as long as you strengthen the immune system, strengthen the cells, mm-hmm. and the healthy cells, because everybody has cancer cells in their body. It's just whether their immune system is strong enough to take care of it, or if their immune system is suppressed and the cancer is able to overtake the healthy cells. So that this would reinforce that argument, and it goes along with everything that I promote and the supplements that I promote. I never claim that a supplement's going to kill cancer. Mm-hmm. I never, as far as my son's situation goes, his body was weak. His immune system was weak. We gave him the accelerated silver and cleaned up his diet and strengthened his immune system, and his immune system took care of the cancer, and he is who he is today. And we found that in so many other issues that we've had in our own family. So that's what's amazing. I don't know, as far as other research goes or testimonials, what else do people find benefit-wise from the Aqua Chi?
Right. Okay. So it's, as I said, we do have people with cancer who use it. And, as you said at the top of the show, there has to be a disclaimer here that you are working with a doctor and, having oversight, with any kind of treatment you do. But by and large, because it's such a, we'll say, global treatment for the body, it can help with many, many different ailments. One of the, just speaking to the reports that we get, we find that people with pain conditions in the lower extremities are helped, and in particular, there is a foot condition related to. There's a foot condition related to diabetes, which can be very painful, and because of the increase in circulation that happens by using the Aqua Chi, it helps to relieve pain, sometimes in gout, sometimes with, I can't remember. Anyway, there are autoimmune diseases in particular seem to get some help with the Aqua Chi.
What about neuropathy when the nerve cells are actually dead?
I was trying to pull the name.
Oh, okay, so that was what exactly, you were thinking of. Okay.
Yeah, that's what I was referring to.
Wonderful, because that ironically, I have a family member with neuropathy. The unfortunate part is he follows Western medicine and he thinks he just wants the magic pill. So, but that's interesting that this helps neuropathy. So, would that how would that work mechanism wise? Is it cleaning out the nerves or providing the electrical charge to the cells in those areas to bring back the nerves?
Yeah, I think what I would say, not knowing the exact mechanism, my theory though is that because it enlivens cells, it can bring back some nerve sensation, and by doing that, obviously the pain would subside as well, because the nerve cells are increasing in health it regenerating. And so that, to me, would be the theory that I have for why that helps people.
Interesting. Yeah. And does it also help with any liver or kidney issues? Any other issues that you've seen really help?
Sometimes with we've gotten certain reports with liver and kidney, in the sense that these are both organs that are help to clean out the blood in the body of toxins. So in a general way, people who have been on dialysis, sometimes they find that they either can reduce the amount of dialysis they have to do, and in some cases totally go off, you know. So the body is remarkable, you know, in the turnaround that can happen. Doctors don't usually, they'll usually kind of say, oh, that's really interesting, when, you know, someone goes into remission from a serious disease, but they don't usually say, how did that happen? How did you do that?
So on the foot bath, there's a timer and it goes to 60 minutes, but I do know there's a cycle of electrical, and I'm not saying this correctly, the positive and negative charge in the body and how you balance it out, and the time of the actual foot bath. I'm not saying this properly, but yeah, can you explain what the time is, what a typical foot bath would take, and the importance of keeping your feet in the bath for a certain amount of time?
Right. Okay. I'll try to address each part of that. First of all, regarding the time that you do a bath, it's generally, you know, 30 to 40 minutes is optimal. It can go longer, and in sometimes with, you know, acute conditions, or if you're going through, you know, having a flu or something like that, going for a little longer in the treatment is a good idea. With regards to, you were talking about the positive and negative charge, the Aqua Chi operates by creating negative ions in the water. That's part of what's going on, I believe. And positive ions are associated with, you know, things like waterfalls and natural springs and things like that. You want to have a water source that is generating negative ions versus positive ions, which are generally found in swamps. So if people have been kind of exploring different foot baths on the market, be careful when a company says that they use both negative and positive ions, because it shows that there's a lack of understanding about what actually, you know, should be present in the bath, you know?
Right. And that is something that I've seen on the market and advertised, and it perked my interest, going, well, am I supposed to have both positive and negative? So right. I'm really glad that you're clearing that up. Would that be the biggest difference with the Aqua Chi versus other foot baths, or what else do we need to look for?
Yeah, that one is one, but the bigger one is that the Aqua Chi, the biocharge created by the Aqua Chi, matches the biological makeup of the cells in the body. So there's a very fine line between giving the cell life and then hurting the cell, because there are, again, other foot baths that would claim, oh, ours is more powerful. And the fact is, we've done testing with other foot baths where, because they believe that more powerful equals good, we did side-by-side treatments. And this was doing, we were demonstrating with things like seeds and the growth of plants and that kind of thing to demonstrate it. But what we found is that some of these foot baths will actually kill cells, because they just don't understand that the balance of this bioelectrical energy that happens with the body. So if we didn't have the research to show the beneficial aspects of the Aqua Chi, then we couldn't do those side by side tests with other foot baths.
Right. Is there anything we need to be careful with, or overdoing it, doing it too much? Any negative side effects to look out for?
We recommend doing it no more than every other day as a natural course. But again, if you're dealing with an acute treatment, every day is going to be fine for a short period of times. I wouldn't recommend doing it, multiple times per day, because you do need to, the body needs to be given some time in between in order to naturally eliminate. And, it's too much of a good thing is like filling a glass of water and then just letting it, overflow. You're not getting any more benefit, but, sometimes people believe, more is better,
Yeah, I'm guilty of that. So it's good to always be reminded that too much is not a good thing. Mm-hmm. Well, we've covered a lot. And is there any other topic or any other question that you think our listeners would like the answer to as far as the Aqua Chi foot bath?
What I'll share is that I've been very general in my answers here. And if anyone wants to get into the nitty gritty of some of the researches, again, you can visit aquachifootbath.com and just send us a note and we'll send that out to you. In particular, this more recent research with Marcy Purnell, we have both her dissertation and an article explaining, in simpler terms, what it all means. But the most exciting thing in general, I think, that comes out of this is that not just for the Aqua Chi, but for medicine in general, I believe the next 10 or 20 years are going to be all about the what we would call subtle energy medicine, which was in the past was kind of viewed as more woo-woo. But we're having more measurements and testing that are actually able to see on a subtle level what's happening with cells, for instance, in the body on an electrical level. So that's pretty exciting.
Yeah, and I've been working with the amp coil, which is a PEMF machine, and I've got other PEMF electrical type devices that I've used and tested out, and the ability for to heal the body with those things, in mm-hmm. addition to a clean diet and herbal supplements, and of course the accelerated silver. It's just amazing. I haven't been sick in 15 years, and my family has, and I talk about my son, but I've got two daughters that all, when I was on this path and journey, they were in preschool and elementary school. And so if anyone else has kids out there, they know how sick kids get during elementary school, preschool, those years. My kids were never sick. We haven't been to the doctor for a sick check in, I want to say, 8 to 10 years. Not my kids have not been on antibiotics. And, from where my son came, he hasn't even had the cold or flu. And right now his two best friends are at home sick and he's fine. And he's obviously been around them. And same with my daughters. They've got friends that are just dropping like flies. Because in sunny California right now, we were just at 80 degrees and now we're at about 4, 6. 60, which is which is very cold for Southern California.
Wow,
we're wimpy out
cold.
Here, right? Mm-hmm. But that drop in temperature is really hard on the body. And that's when the sicknesses and the viruses and bacteria like to get in and invade the body and take over. And our family is able to stay above it just with all of these things. And I was going to mention a few things that I've noticed with my own experience. My son used to play water polo, and that's right when I got the foot bath. And oh my goodness, the smell of chlorine that came out of his body when he did it. It was just, he smelled up the whole room, but you knew that this was working because it was pulling all of that chlorine out of his body. And mine, whenever I know that I have a gallbladder issue, because I'm very in tune with my own body, and when my liver's dumping or my gallbladder is suffering, the color changes. And I've also noticed if I know I'm fighting a fungus or a candida, that there's more bubbles to the water. Mm-hmm. So the water does change depending on what issue I'm personally fighting, which is very, it's sad, a weird word, but it's satisfying to know that this device is really helping heal my body and take things out that need to be out and that are, it's strengthening my immune system.
You see those reflections, and each person, you know, has a different outcome, but, you know, it's a testament to what you're able to observe with your own, what's going on in your own body and what's happening in the water. So that's a very interesting thing. Do you have any kind of thoughts about how your other family members have, worked with it?
So I'm the most consistent. My kids get on it and I'll just put them in front of the TV or they'll do their homework as they are doing it. It's very relaxing. They always want to do it right before bed because it makes them a little sleepy. We've seen an improvement in water retention if someone's suffering from a little edema, and then just improving their immune system. If they're feeling something come on, they'll do a foot bath. And it's very relaxing and enjoyable. It's not something that you sit there and think, I have to make time for this. I don't want to do this. Mm-hmm. And the nice thing, like I said, I do it as I'm sitting at my computer and working, and it's just under my desk. So it's very relaxing for me to have your feet in some nice warm water as you're working away.
I thought it was interesting that you said, I'm in a bath right now.
Yeah. Who knew? I feel productive as I'm doing it, but I feel relaxed when I'm done. So it's a great combination.
All right.
But before I ask my last question, why don't you tell people where they can find you?
Okay. The website is aquachifootbath.com. And for listeners today, I just wanted to offer a coupon if anyone's interested in purchasing. The coupon to use is the code SHOW100. SHOW100, all one word, and you can apply that if you want to purchase one.
Wonderful. That's very generous of you. And I want to end with, what are the top three things that you do on a daily basis to accelerate your body, your mind, and your spirit? And I hope doing a foot bath is one of them.
I wish I could say I did it every day, but, you know, I try to keep at it. So the three things that I do are, one is I meditate. Two is that I drink plenty of water. And three, I do breathing exercises because I believe that water and air are, you know, two of the things that we can't live without. And I take a conscious effort to, along with nutrition, to work at those every day too.
It's so true. And I've talked about stress and cortisol levels and how you can gain weight by not even eating anything just because you're not breathing, you're not meditating, and you're carrying too much stress. So I cannot agree with you more as far as air and water. I did my yoga class yesterday and I feel 1,000 times better than on the days that I don't. Mm-hmm. So well, thank you so much, Michael. And we're going to go to a short commercial break and be right back to answer the questions you have sent in. And we'll also talk about the second fat-storing hormone, insulin. Last week, we talked about cortisol. So I wanted to continue with insulin and how insulin could be to blame for your weight gain and any other health issues you might be having.
Are you wanting to optimize your physical, mental, and emotional health? Visit www.acceleratedhealthproducts.com. Accelerated Health Products to detox, reset, and rebuild your immune system naturally and to accelerate your body, mind, and spirit with cutting-edge supplements and solutions. Get Sara Banta's personal advice on a protocol just right for you. That's www.acceleratedhealthproducts.com.
And we're back. And first, before I get into insulin, I wanted to tell Alvin, he asked a question at the beginning of the show, what is the difference between colloidal and the other silver you mentioned? Thanks for asking the question. The accelerated silver, which is a scalar silver. So what is the biggest difference. It's penetration. Most of the colloidal silvers on the market are physical in nature, and therefore all the those companies have to argue that the particle size is the most important. The smaller the particle size, the better the penetration. That's true, but accelerated silver is an energetic product. So what does that mean? Scalar in physics occurs when you take an element like silver or gold. We do carry an accelerated gold, and electronically pushes it to a state where it loses its identity as a traceable element. So it acts more like a gas. So as a gas, it actually has 100% penetration versus only 5 to 6% penetration with any other colloidal silver. And because there's so little silver in it, you could drink gallons of it and you really are only drinking the distilled water, and there's no negative side effects. So that's the biggest difference. I'm going to go into it more probably next week on really what the scalar technology is. And Ethel asks, you say people with chronic issues can be helped. What about a person with chronic kidney or liver issues? Yes, they can be helped. And I recommend going to Accelerated Health Radio on YouTube and listening to the How to Cure the Incurable. I've got a whole protocol on supplements, what to use to take care of all of those issues. And really, those are your filters. And with the foot bath, you are taking away some of the burden on your liver and your kidneys, but also with the detox powder on the website, Accelerated Cellular Detox Powder, and the accelerated silver, you're gently detoxing your body and not taking the burden off the liver and kidney issues. Ethel, feel free to email me directly and tell me what your issues are, and I'm happy to help. And then Rachel's asking, is there any interaction with the accelerated silver with any medication or other supplements? Actually, it helps enhance the effect of those supplements. So it will help you with what other supplements or medication you are taking. So anyways, I want to get into the insulin. Insulin's main job is to keep your blood sugar low. We actually only have 1 teaspoon or only 5 grams of sugar in the blood at any time. So when you eat more than that, it's insulin's job to take that glucose and put it in the cells and get it out of the blood. In other words, it is taking glucose and storing it as fat in the cells. So as you're releasing insulin, the insulin immediately cancels out the 6 other fat-burning hormones. It's working on storing the glucose as fat. So if you're not eating food or you're eating only fat, you won't be releasing insulin, which then allows the fat-burning hormones to continue to do their job. This is the fat-storing hormone that low-carb ketogenic diets minimize, which you've heard me talk about. So think of it this way. All of your fat stores are like good quality nutritious food in that basement freezer with that lock on it that you can't get to. All of the sugar and the carbs you eat are like the food in your pantry, quick and easy to get. So if your body's releasing insulin, it locks that freezer of fat stores in your body and blocks those nutritious fuel sources down in the basement. And the only fuel source it knows how to access is the food in the pantry, the quick sugar and carbs you're craving and that your cravings are making you want. When you're in a ketogenic state or on a ketogenic diet or fasting, your body learns how to unlock that freezer in the basement, and it has unlimited stores of fuel to start burning. So how do you know if you're fat burning? Well, if you have cravings, they are signaling you that you're running on sugar for energy and your body's in a fat storing mode. If you're able to go long periods of time without being hungry, this is a sign that your body's able to tap into its own fat stores for that energy and fuel. So if you get hungry in between meals, this is a sign that your body is searching for sugar and does not know how to unlock those fat stores. And everybody has thousands and thousands of calories of fat on their body, even if you're an elite athlete with low body fat percentage. However, if your body doesn't know how to access those fat stores due to being dependent on sugar and glucose, then you'll be hungry in between meals. Then as you eat, you release insulin and shut off all 6 fat-burning hormones. This mechanism triggers storing any glucose or fat into the fat cells. And our bodies can make new fat cells, but they can never get rid of them. So once you have new fat cells, you can only shrink them, and then they'll have a propensity to want to fill up again. And some call this a set point. And that's why when you do a low-calorie diet and you lose weight and the fat cells shrink, those fat cells are still thinking it's that fat. So say you're at 300 pounds, you go down to 150, those fat cells are still wanting to be a 300-pound person with an appetite for a 300-pound person, unless you are on a low-carb diet, which helps you tap into those fat stores as energy. Insulin makes you gain weight all over the body, versus estrogen, which makes you store fat in the hips and the waist. And cortisol causes you to store fat in the belly. So depending on where you're storing your fat or your weight, you can tell which hormone is out of whack. So how do you release or reduce insulin? Number one, you intermittent fast. When you squeeze your eating within a shorter period of time, not eating for an extended period of time, you're giving your body a break or releasing insulin. When the body's in a fasted state, not only is it burning fat for fuel off the body, but it's also turning on many healing genes and mechanisms like autophagy, which allows the body to clean out disease cells, cancer cells, recycle proteins and amino acids, reduce inflammation, and turn on other anti-aging mechanisms. So as we're talking about the foot bath and all of the benefits it's doing, you can enhance that by doing intermittent fasting and turning on all these healing genes and recycling genes as well. Number two, a low-carb, high-fat ketogenic diet. Insulin is triggered when you eat sugar and carbs. So when you're eating a diet high in fat, moderate protein, and keep your carbs under 20 grams a day, focus on only having green vegetables as your carbohydrates, your insulin stays low and you continue to stay in fat-burning mode. Lastly, number three, exogenous ketones. Ketone supplements, and I carry one on my website on accelerated health products as well, can be taken to put your body into ketosis within 30 minutes and turn on the fat burning right away. So if you don't do it with exogenous ketones, it might take you up to 2 to 3 weeks to switch from the carb burning to the ketone burning or fat burning. This teaches your body how to burn ketones for fuel or fat for fuel and starts to learn how to access its own fat stores. Your appetite is suppressed, your cravings for sugar and carbs and alcohol go away, your mental and physical energy increases, and you truly feel your best. So those are my tips on how to reduce the insulin in the body. And thank you for joining us today with Michael and the Aqua Chi Foot Bath. And remember, you have the coupon code on his website for show 100, which is an amazing deal. I wish I had that back when I bought mine. And then also, if I can help you with any of your health issues personally, contact me, Sara Banta, at sara@acceleratedhealthproducts.com or directly through the website. And I'm happy to put together a protocol for you. I know sometimes it's hard to do and know where to start. You can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, under Accelerated Health Products, and my YouTube channel under Accelerated Health Radio. Don't miss next week's show, where we'll talk to Rick Paddock about the mind being the supercomputer and its ability to facilitate renovation, repair, and update all areas of our lives. Just as we can renovate and repair our physical house, we can do the same with our home, to our soul and spirit, as I talk about accelerating your body, mind, and spirit. We can chat about hypnosis, meditation, intention, self-love, self-belief, and much more. Also, you can find the supplements we've talked about and many more informational videos on my website, acceleratedhealthproducts.com. And on my site, you can use coupon W4HC20 for 20% off site-wide, including all of the supplements we mentioned today. So thanks again for joining us here on Accelerated Health Radio. If you have any topics that you want me to cover, email me directly or send me a message through Facebook or Instagram. I'd love to answer your questions. And it being going into the holidays and Thanksgiving, we can also touch on what to do and how to handle the holidays in a healthy way. Thanks again for joining us here on Accelerated Health Radio, and we will see you again next week.
Are you wanting to optimize your physical, mental, and emotional health? Visit www.acceleratedhealthproducts.com. Accelerated Health Products to detox, reset, and rebuild your immune system naturally and to accelerate your body, mind, and spirit with cutting-edge supplements and solutions. Get Sara Banta's personal advice on a protocol just right for you. That's www.acceleratedhealthproducts.com. Thank you for joining us today on W4HC Radio for Accelerated Health Radio with Sara Banta. Make sure to tune in every week at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to uncover your highest potential through natural and innovative wellness modalities.